Today's reading is from John chapter 13, verses 1 to 17. Jesus washes his disciples' feet. It was just before the Passover festival. Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave the world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The evening meal was in progress, and the devil had already prompted Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had put all things under his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. So he got up from the meal, took off his outer clothing, and wrapped a towel around his waist. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet, drying them with the towel that was wrapped around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus replied, "You do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand." "No," said Peter, "you shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no part with me." Then Lord Simon Peter replied, "Not just my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus answered, "Those who have had a bath need only to wash their feet. Their whole body is clean. And you are clean, though not every one of you." For he knew who was going to betray him, and that was why he said not every one was clean. When he had finished washing their feet, he put on his clothes and returned to his place. "Do you understand what I have done for you?" he asked them. "You call me teacher and Lord, and rightly so, for that is what I am. Now that I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also should wash one another's feet. I have set you an example that you should do as I have done for you. Very truly I tell you, no servant is greater than his master, nor is a messenger greater than the one who sent him. Now that you know these things, you will be blessed if you do them." Thanks be to God for this reading of his holy word. In biblical times, it was the job of the servants in the house to welcome any visitors to the house by washing the mud and dust off the roads, off their feet as they arrived. Jesus humbled himself and willingly took on the role of a servant when he knelt to wash his disciples' feet. The guild motto is, "Whose we are and whom we serve." Guild members hope to follow Christ's example in their lives, serving the people around them. Through the National Guild projects, we look for ways to reach out and serve other people who are disadvantaged in many ways, wherever they are around the world, showing them God's love. And now a prayer. And this is a prayer from Life and Work magazine. Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change, thank you for the eternity of your love and the constancy of your purpose. Enable us to adapt to a world with virus variants, climate change, and millions of migrant people desperate for sanctuary and inclusion. Empower us to act for a world where children are safe and nurtured, where all have access to a home, an education, and a living wage. Father of lights, may we embody change for a brighter, better world. Empower us as members of the body of Christ, charged with good news, to walk humbly alongside, to love tenderly, and to act justly towards the poor, the outcast, and the powerless, and all whom you came to save. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever, your mission and our mission has not changed. Amen.